Speaking of neighbors, I'm supposed to give you a shout out from Tyler Gilbert too.
I
forgot until I saw my hat there. I'm actually wearing his toque.
Tyler. Oh, you are too.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I don't even know where my camera is.
How do you know each other? We first met at there was this folk music conference called Folk Alliance that happened in, we were in Kansas City. That's actually, I met a ton of Saskatchewan-based artists there. I met like Megan Nash and Nick Faye, Josh Gonzalez, and then Tyler. And we just like formed a little group and like went around to all the different places, like all the different showcases together. It was really nice. And then from there, I think the last time I saw Tyler, we played like a show in Moose Jaw together a couple years ago. He's a great guy.
Nice. He's so like, I haven't met him in person. I met him on the show, right? And then, you know, I kind of text with him every now and again, but I freaking love that guy. Like, I don't know him personally at all, but there's something about him, and I'm almost scared to say it, because if my interpretation on him is way off, then I don't want to like insult him or make him feel bad, but like, I freaking love that guy, man. And I'd bend over backwards for him. He's good shit in my book.
He's a solid dude. Sure.
Yeah. Makes me laugh. I think he's freaking hilarious.
I bet the smoke alarm is still going off.
I hear it so often. I think I just tuned it out.
No, he actually found it for the record. Yeah. For all you fans who your avid listeners out there, he did find the smoke detector on top of his furnace and he removed the batteries. But I think it took him like two, 3 weeks.
That's awesome.
Horrendous.
Oh, I know. Right.
So Skye, I'm not sure if you know the backstory of this one.
I don't know if I saw this.
Okay, so we had Tyler on a couple of months ago, whatever it was, throughout the whole session, we just hear this beep.
Oh, is that beeping?
So I called him out on it. He's like, "You need to change the batteries on the smoke alarm." He's like, "What, really?" And all of a sudden he's like, "Oh, yeah, I guess so, because I heard it before, but I tuned it out. I don't even know what a damn thing is." Oh, okay. Well, whatever.
He was painting, then, so everything, his whole house was like out of whack because he was painting, right? So he didn't know where it was, but he could hear it every minute. It would go off.
Wherever it is, I think I heard it.
Because the battery was low. Then a week goes by.
A week later, Joe, who you were a guest on last week?
Yes.
Or 2 weeks ago, whatever it was. Yeah, so Joe has a talk with Tyler, and I don't know, 15 minutes in, Joe goes, "Is that your freaking smoke alarm still?" And
it's crazy. Is that your goddamn smoke detector still going?
Oh, it's still beeping. Oh shit.
And it was still beeping, yeah.
Oh man, that would be so annoying to live
right?
with. Like,
I wouldn't be able to do it. Yeah. But yeah, so okay. Good news, he found it. Good.
He found it, and he didn't change the batteries, he just removed them.
Took it out.
Yeah.
Oh, that guy.
That's the best ending.
Right? But that's perfect. Like stuff like that. Like even just what made me laugh so hard about it was when we called him out on it in the episode.
Yeah.
Just his reaction. He was just like, "Oh, that's what that is?
Oh, is that beeping?"
You know, it's been going on for a week. It was just, he really, I think was the moment when I fell in love with Tyler.
Totally.
Made me think of like how innocent he is for somebody who can just like thrash and shred so hard on the guitar.
Totally.
And be so kick ass. And he's just like nonchalant and easygoing. That was perfect. Yeah.
That's such a good story. Hey, Tyler.